A very good morning to all and a very, very happy Diwali to everyone. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 27th October, Sunday, on the front page you have BJP-JJP alliance to form government in Haryana. So we had seen this yesterday too, the front page news that the two parties are going to come together in Haryana to form government and Deputy CM would be from JJP, the JJP leader. And JJP is a new political party as such, which has been formed from INLD, the political party of Haryana. So this is Jananayak Janata Party. And here you have Nagaland Manipur brace for likely Naga peace accord. So this is regarding Naga peace accord, which would be concluded between the government and the Naga separatist group, INSC and IM. So it is seeking greater Nagaland, that is merging Naga inhabited areas of Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, together into Nagaland, and also it wants a separate flag and constitution for the Nagas. So ceasefire agreement has been signed by NSC and IM with the central government in 1997, and you know, the interlocutor who is there, you know, speaking on behalf of the government with the group is R N Ravi, and a framework agreement as such has also been signed in 2015, and you can see now a final accord may come forth. So possibility of announcement of this Naga peace accord has led to administrations in Nagaland and Manipur to issue series of orders that include one, cautioning people against hoarding fuel and essential commodities. So states have stepped up security also in this context. So how people would react to this Naga peace accord is what is a concern. So here you can see, so the police has been asked to provide security to officials in the interest of securing equitable distribution and fair prices of essential commodities for a period of 15 days. Also, fuel outlets have been given directions too, that they shall not sell out fuel in barrels, because the concerns which are being raised as such makes people also hoard, which results in increase in prices and scarcity of essentials. So that's why government also sprung into action. And here you have cities' air quality stays in poor category. This is regarding Delhi. And here you have Assam tea growers may take artificial intelligence route to recovery. So drones are used to address shortage of workers as well as spray hazardous pesticides with precision in the tea gardens, the tea farms. And this is bulk of blocked tweets Kashmir centric. So this is press advocacy group called Committee to Protect Journalists, which has its headquarters in US. It has said that large number of tweets which were blocked in India by Twitter since August 2017 were shared by accounts that focus on Kashmir. So these have been blocked. On page 9 you have illegal structures cannot be rebuilt. So Supreme Court has told Maharashtra government to conduct geo-mapping of cities to stop unauthorized construction. So it should get all cities where population is 50 lakh or more to be geo-mapped to easily track and control illegal constructions in them. So this is the direction of the Supreme Court to the state government. So it said that all over the country, we find that when people raise illegal constructions, it is claimed that the said construction has been existing for long. So answer to this is to get geomapping done. So the relevant technology is GIS, Geographic Information System. So if on Google Maps one can get a road view, we see no reason why this technology cannot be used by the municipal corporations to ascertain when this construction has been done. Then this is activists flag underreporting of sexual crimes against boys. So it is said 2.8% of crimes against children mention boys. So why is it not clearly indicated is the question being raised by activists. So this was the 2017 report of National Crime Records Bureau. So you can see. So it shows that most cases remain undisclosed. And then you have six lakh lamps on banks of Saryu set record. So this is a new record which has been created in Ayodhya. 6 lakh earthen lamps or divyas were lit on the banks of river Saryu on the eve of Diwali. So this is Guinness World Record which has been set. On page 11, you have citizenship bill to run into fierce protests. So Home Ministry is planning to move the citizenship amendment bill during winter session of parliament, but the northeastern states are against it. And you should know the bill seeks to provide citizenship to six persecuted minorities, that is non-Muslims in Muslim majority countries, Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh. So these are Hindus, Jains, Sikhs, Parsis, Christians and Buddhists. So if they came to India before 2014, at any time before 2014, they will be facilitated with citizenship. So that is the amendment bill, but northeastern states are against this because the NRC exercise in Assam and NRC like exercises which other states in northeast also want to have actually is to detect illegal migrants. So then if they are, if these are migrants from these communities and have come before 2014, then they are no longer illegal. They will be legalized given citizenship through this bill. Then this is Indian Ocean Rim to get boost with UAE Bangladesh at helm. So this is regarding Indian Ocean Rim Association. The ministerial meet would be held in Abu Dhabi. And India continues to promote its official policy of coordination, cooperation and partnership in maritime domain. So the meet would be in November. On international page you have 20 Vietnamese among those found dead in UK. So as many as 20 Vietnamese citizens are feared among 39 people found dead in a truck in Britain. So this is actually shocking. They had used this route. They are using dangerous trafficking routes to enter into Europe. So these are undocumented migrants who are looking for better lives in UK, in European countries, and the way they are, you know, brought here is dangerous, and we can see this death has shocked the world. Below you have Iraqi security forces clamp down on protesters. So nearly 200 people have died in anti-government protests in October 2019 in Iraq. So protests are taking place in Baghdad and across the south of Iraq. A parliamentary session has been scheduled to discuss these renewed protests, but it was cancelled after it failed to reach a quorum. So minimum attendance was not there. So these anti-government rallies going on since October 1, and 200 people have died and thousands wounded in these protests. Then there's no important news on business page. Then on Sundays you also have FAQ coverage, like important issues, frequently asked questions kind of coverage. So there are three important issues picked up here. The first one is, how green are Deepavali crackers? So this is complete detail about green crackers, because Supreme Court intervention had said that only green crackers should be sold. So these are considered to be less polluting, so but they're a little costly too. So how are they faring? How green are these crackers? This is being looked into in this article, which is very important. And this is the world of mimic organs. So this says, can organoids derived from stem cells be used in disease treatments? So a cross section of brain organoid with each color marking a different type of brain cell has been shown here, you can see. So these are called organoids derived from stem cells. Can they be used for disease treatment? So this is being looked into. So these are futuristic technologies which are being spoken of. And this is, why have the Naga peace talks stumbled? So Naga peace talks have stumbled. The deal has not come forth. This is front page news also today. The deal would be coming forth soon. So the consequences would be there of what the demands which Naga separatist groups are making on neighboring states. So this is what has been discussed, that is this going to have an effect on neighboring states, and what is the role of NSC and IAM in resolving the issue? Then on Sundays, you also have science and technology coverage. So here the first coverage is, novel method found to kill dormant TB bacteria in stem cells. So these are Delhi-based researchers who have found that inhibiting lipid synthesis inside stem cells, means lipid is fat. So if fat is not formed, inhibited means it's not allowed to be formed inside stem cells that produce bone cells. This can help in killing TB bacteria that are found inside the stem cells in dormant state. So means if the TB bacteria in stem cells are killed, then this, it is safely shielded from the host immune system and TB drugs as such. So this is here. So bacteria actually hide inside lipid droplets. And because of that, stem cells cannot kill them. So if lipid synthesis does not take place, then you know these TB bacteria cannot hide. Then here below you have new class of quantum materials for clean energy technology. So this is a study which has found that nanostructures would show properties different from common metals like gold or silver. So this is new class of quantum materials which can be used for clean energy technology as such too. So these are called direct metals. Direct metals, it is said, differ from normal metals in that the energy depends linearly on the momentum. So this is key aspect. Normal metals are good conductors of electricity, like gold and silver are good conductors. So the quality of conduction means the way energy depends on the momentum of the electrons. So direct metals are, you know, having this difference. So this difference is responsible for their unique properties. Semi-direct metals are also there, which behave like direct metals in one direction and like normal metals in perpendicular direction. So these are the, this is regarding this new class of quantum materials. So you should know about this terminology, direct metals. So such materials would be transparent to light of a given frequency and polarization when it is incident along a particular direction. And material would be opaque to the same light when it falls on it from a different direction. So there are many applications for such transparent conducting films. Common example being touch screen used in mobiles, etc. Then on Sundays, you also have dispatches coverage in which important issues from across the globe are listed. So first one is smudged beaches, ghost ships and a clueless government. So this is regarding Brazil. A massive oil spill here has dumped 900 tons of sludge and has sparked many conspiracy theories. So this is what has happened in Brazil. And this is in Pakistan. It is said, speaking their mind to honor Asma Jahangir's legacy. So second Asma Jahangir conference has been called on to fight for justice, freedom and human rights. So Jahangir co-founded the Human Rights Commission of Pakistan and played a prominent role in 2007 lawyers movement that challenged the rule of military dictator Pervez Musharraf. So this Asma Jahangir Foundation has organized the second conference to commemorate the human rights lawyer who died in 2018. And here you have a payment system that puts Zuckerberg in the dock. So this is an important issue regarding Libra. So Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg was quizzed over 5 hours by the US Congress committee on Facebook's launch of Libra, a cryptocurrency kind of, you know, planned out to be issued. So you should know everything about that. And this is the long march of Chinese gamers in the new arena. So this is regarding gaming companies, Chinese gaming companies. So censorship at home is making them bet on Asia Pacific markets. Then the last page has sports coverage. So these are the important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for today. Thank you.